When we're hot for learning, we see those challenges as opportunities to reach, to stretch, to grow ourselves. As opposed to when we're cooler for learning, we're more apathetic towards improvement. We don't see the point in learning and developing. We're content with where we are, which isn't sustainable in this era, with the way technology is going, with the way your company is growing, right? We've got to continue to reach, stretch, and grow to stay relevant and valuable. Otherwise, we get left behind and we become obsolete. Now, I believe that we all have a learning temperature. On a Fahrenheit scale of 0 to 100, right now, sitting in this chair, what's your learning temperature? And what would happen if it was 1 or 2 degrees warmer? What more could you be learning right now? Now take it back to the baseline and lower it 1 or 2 degrees. If you were 1 or 2 degrees cooler, what would you not know currently? What challenge would you not have said yes to that led to a skill, that led to you getting the job that you have, in the industry that you have, to the quality of life that you have, to this moment right here? Now the beauty is, I believe that as human beings, we're hardwired for lifelong learning. I mean, it's just like a car. It takes the most amount of time and energy to start it up and to get going. But once we go 0 to 10, going 10 to 20 is a little easier. 20 to 30 is easier, 30 to 40 is easier. By the time we get on the freeway, 50 to 60 is virtually effortless because we're on a roll. We've got momentum. And the same applies for our learning endeavors. Once we're warmed up, we're more flexible, we're more malleable. We're adaptable, we're ready for that change, and we embrace that change. My dad was a professor at the University of Georgia for over 40 years. Now, I was telling my dad about Elijah's crawling and how it would soon lead to walking, and he said, you know, well, that sounds like an interesting science experiment. And so what I wanted to do was I wanted to conduct my own little experiment. So I accurately quantified Elijah's learning process from day one for successful crawling to day one for successful walking. In that time period, there were 92 days. We did 3 training sessions per day, 20 attempts per session, 60 attempts per day. 92 days later, 5,520 failed attempts for 1 step. And the cool thing is that we all did that. We've all given ourselves permission. We've all been ignited by that possibility. And I think the key as adults is to be the childlike scientist. In other words, I was sitting there in between my dad in his 80s, my son in his onesies, and I was wondering, how can I blend these two together to be that childlike scientist? To have a process for learning, right? A strategy for learning, but to rekindle that passion. And I believe that as adults, once we can rekindle that passion, we make learning fun, then we become unstoppable. When learning becomes fun, we become unstoppable. And there's ways that we can do this. Surrounding ourselves with people who are like-minded, peers that are inspired to reach and stretch and grow themselves. We can make little games, little challenges to do this. And we don't have to get bogged down in the macro perspective of being a master at something. We can get micro on it. We can celebrate those small successes. And when we celebrate those small successes, that reinforces and re-encourages ourselves to reach, to stretch, and to grow.